It was a race that tested tenacity, tactics, and boat handling skills. It was a race that demanded physical endurance and mental resilience. Organised by the Cruising Yacht Club of Australia in collaboration with the Royal Yacht Club of Tasmania, the 2021 Rolex Sydney Hobart was a true reminder of what makes this 628 nautical mile race one of the world's most renowned offshore challenges and indeed sporting contests. From the blistering start on Sydney Harbour, through the early taxing heavy weather conditions, to the more tactically exacting finishing stages, the race has provided an almost perfect examination of ocean racing ability. Blackjack was the first of the 88 boat fleet to cross the finish off of Hobart. Following an exhilarating and captivating battle with Law Connect and SHK Scallywag that lasted most of the course. Then, half a day later, it was the turn of the 52-foot Ichiban to reach the line, and after an equally enthralling encounter with her closest rivals, Ichiban secured the overall win on corrected time.
It's amazing to be part of the history and the fabric of the Rolex Sydney to Hobart race with a back-to-back win. I mean, we're just so elated. Most races to Hobart do test the entire boat and the crew, but I think this year is probably more than ever. The wave conditions that we saw really first through the first 24 hours of the race, really creating big issues for the boats. And then you had that very complicated tactical situation for the rest of the race that really enabled, you know, decision-making to be absolutely critical to have a chance of winning the race. For about 2.5 days, we didn't see a boat at all during the whole race, and then we were match racing Celestial, which was great for both crews and made it a lot more enjoyable. I mean, everyone loves a race. That's why we're in there.